The future is certainly uncertain, but that does not mean that we can't predict what is going to happen. Tech is evolving at a pace that is faster than ever before. As well, AI is a huge part of it. If you've been thinking about how AI is going to evolve and change our lives, then you've come to the right place. This is the time-lapse of the future of artificial intelligence. So, will AI become our best friends? Or like the movie shows, will try ruling over us? Let's explore together. They say to predict the future, you must look at the past. Looking at history, artificial intelligence is not that old. The oldest traces only date back to the mid-1900s. Just 70 years, and look how far we've come. From video calls to Amazon to Uber. Who would have thought this kind of thing would ever exist? AI is still very young. You could say we are in the dinosaur era of technology. So what would AI be like in, say, 10 or 20 years? Before 2100, artificial intelligence is already doing so much. One tap in Google and you have the information of the whole world in your hands. It is responsible for connecting millions of people, for social needs, and of course, providing people with jobs. In the upcoming years, all these algorithms will just get better. But hey, we're not here to discuss all this boring stuff, are we? Let's move on to the interesting part. If you follow tech, then you must be aware of Elon Musk's Neuralink project. It's basically a chipset that would be planted in your brain. What does it do? Everything that a smartphone can do, basically. It's just your brain turning into a computer, from listening to music, communication, sending texts and calls. Everything, just by using your brain. Sounds pretty interesting, doesn't it? That's not all. Metaverse is on its way to making a grand debut in the world of technology. It's going to be a totally virtual reality inside of VR. The possibilities inside of it are endless. You can do anything and everything imaginable. And you know what's better? You can code applications and designs yourself, which means that the only boundary inside Metaverse is our imagination. 2100 to 2400. That's just the beginning of neural technology. By 2100 and 2200, it's possible that we could be able to do electronically aided telepathy. No, I am not bluffing at all. You can search it up. Just like Neuralink, startup companies like Kernel and Control Labs are working on crazy stuff like these. Sitting with your friend in a class and have to share a joke? Just use the chipset in your brain and boom! You are both caught laughing like maniacs and sent out of the class and maybe disconnected from it. What do I mean? Remember I mentioned Metaverse? It's already pretty innovative, but as we know, science always evolves and so will Metaverse. Experts say that in the future, as in maybe in a few centuries, most of our lives would be spent inside virtual reality. The art and graphics would be so much better that it would be impossible to tell if you are inside a VR or you are actually in reality. It's only possible that school, offices, and even parties would just occur online. It's much more convenient that way. However, all these raise some important questions though. Would there not be hackers? What about our privacy and online security? Believe me or not, online security and protection inside the metaverse would be a big thing in the future. So, is AI just going to make us more addicted to the internet? Can they be beneficial to our health or not? Of course, they can be. And this is where nanotechnology makes its entrance. Nanotech is still under development, but in the future, it's going to be the heart of health and medical sciences. Since nanotechnology is basically tech but on the scale of nanometers, they can be used to trace everything that goes around in the entire body. Just think of it this way. Mini robots would be injected into your bloodstream, and since blood is pumped to the whole body, it can basically give you information about everything that is going around in the body. It can be helpful to detect cancer before it becomes large enough to harm the body. It can be used to make mini medicines that would only act in the target cells where it's supposed to. 2400 to 3000. However, after the 2400s to the 3000s, nanotechnology would evolve and it would merge with neurotech to produce something that's even more insane. Well, just how minibots can enter the blood and study all your cells, they can also enter your brain cells and possibly study it too. Combined with the power of neurotechnology, memory loss wouldn't be a thing anymore. mental health would be greatly enhanced through techniques like meditation and holotropic breathing. And all of this is not a saying of mine. All of these statements are coming straight from the research done by psychologist Stanislav Grof. So far, we have just been discussing AI that is directly related to our body or how it would directly affect us. Let's talk about supercomputers now. Things that will completely change our understanding of the whole universe itself. Now, supercomputers aren't something new. They're being researched for a long time, and though there hasn't been much success with it, by the 3000s, they would be the powerhouse controlling everything. Supercomputers are computers but can calculate much faster and are way more efficient since they use the principles of quantum physics. Fancy terms, eh? Well, some of the benefits of supercomputers would be that we would be able to predict and learn more about climate change, earthquakes, and a lot of other natural disasters. They can be used to fold proteins too, which can be a massive achievement since it's key to curing diseases like Alzheimer's and cystic fibrosis. Genetic engineering would benefit highly from supercomputers too, since it can compute and simulate all the different possibilities of combining different genes. Why is it helpful? Enabling us to know the human DNA better, which would help us find cures to different genetic diseases and even find ways to prevent them. Supercomputers are the only way we can know and simulate more about black holes, wormholes, and of course study the Big Bang to a deeper level. Plus the fact that it can possibly even map the entire bloodstream. Oh, and yes, you must be pretty surprised to know that we haven't done that yet, right? We are pretty dumb, you know. Or are we? Even though supercomputers compute more than a million times faster than regular computers, they are still rookies compared to our brains. I find it quite funny how our brain is complimenting itself when I am saying this. Regardless, back to topic. Back in 2006, researchers at the École Polytechnique Fédérale de Lausanne in Switzerland successfully simulated a 10,000 neuron chunk of a rat brain called a neocortical unit. It's a tiny section of the brain, but with the help of supercomputers and 1,000 years of evolving technology, some experts say that it's entirely possible to even build an entire brain. Right before we jump into the last part, if you've made it this far, make sure to like and subscribe for more content like this. 3000s and after. Now, if that is possible, and even if it's not, we would be able to create robots that are way more capable of doing what we do now. That brings us to an important question, which is probably why you clicked on this video. Will artificial intelligence be superior to us? It's quite a tricky question, but look back to all the things that we spoke about. Neurotechnology, nanotechnology, supercomputers, making artificial brains, having the ability to have the information of your whole brain in a chipset, and all that. It's normal that all this information would be stored in some kind of a cloud. And, well, they can be accessed in illegal manners, can they be not? Robots can certainly turn against us knowing that they are better than us. But wait, we code them. We tell them what to do. Machine learning is a thing, and it's true that through algorithms, AI can learn things on its own. However, as long as we design the algorithm and have control over AI, nothing harmful can happen to us. By then, Earth would not be the only planet humans would be living on, and artificial intelligence would play a big part in our journey. Not only would it design better and more efficient rockets to travel way faster, but it's going to help us in nuclear science too, enabling us to harness energy even more efficiently. The world would change a lot, and with that, our lifestyle too. But one thing that is never changing from this moment onwards is our dependence on artificial intelligence. It will only make our lives better, but it will certainly come with a cost. The cost? Uncertain. Be sure to watch Newest Robots That Will Blow Your Mind.